Hey everybody, welcome back. I showed you guys last episode at the very end there that I had found a beaker, so I wanted to wait till the morning here and show you guys what to do next. And we can craft glue now. And we only need 5, but I'm gonna make 10. So now that we can make glue, we can now actually get our frickin' table set up. Now we're gonna need some nails to do it, so we need about 20 of those. So what we'll do is we'll go like this, we'll go nails, put in up for 50, I guess. Won't take long for those. And all I did last night was craft up about 100 stone axes and about 200 frickin' wooden clubs. And you'll notice I turned off my quests. I just realized up here you could actually toggle your quests on and off, so I did that. But I'll show you guys. Weaponsmithing's now at 41, which doesn't help much, because I still need to get to 50 before I can even craft the next level of weapon, which would be the sledgehammer. So now that we've got this, and now that we've got, well, 2 more of this, we'll have to wait. Then we'll be able to make our crafting table and set that up. Trying to get my tool smithing up so that we can get our gardening going so we can craft a hoe and a pickaxe and help us farm resources a little bit faster. Today here, this morning, after I get this crafting table set up, we're gonna have to go and farm a bunch of wood and stones since I used all those up, and we'll plant these as well. Let's see here, 5, excellent. Grab the rest of it up here. And we are gonna need to make a workbench right here. What am I missing? Oh, I need 50 wood. Okay. Do I even have 50 wood? No, I do not. So we're gonna have to go grab wood, and we'll be able to make it. Had to kill a zombie down here in the middle of the night. It took 1 hit. Not a big deal. Our trees are starting to grow, which is good. They do take a while. I've doubled the tree growth rate, so they're, you know, not growing so fast. I noticed that Alpha 14, they reduce the amount of trees that are actually around in the biome. So it's actually kind of harder to find trees, which is actually pretty good. Probably reduce lag like a little bit too as well. I'm gonna need goldenrod as well, so I might as well pick that up. We need stones. Finish this off so I can hit it. Awesome. So grab a bit of wood and then we'll be able to craft our crafting table. Thank God. I was worried it was going to take a lot longer to get a beaker to even get glue or anything. We got real lucky there. So just grab a couple trees here, nothing too much. Just keep grinding every night, trying to get our tool skill up and our weapon skill. Now I can craft like a 200 and some quality, about 230, I can't remember exactly what quality level, but so I could upgrade our barb club too when we get back. In fact, I just want to quickly make a couple stone axes here. And then with our workbench set up, we can actually start a lot of other things as well. Well, now that we got a beaker, we can start a lot of other things as well, now that we can actually get a steady supply of glue coming in. Get our tailoring table set up. Get a sewing machine. Something I didn't show you guys in the last series that I'd like to show you guys in this one. It is day 7, so next episode will be the day 7 horde, and like I said earlier, I'm not pissing around. I'm not gonna take any chances or risk anything. I'm gonna roleplay it like I would in real life. If I were, you know, hiding away from a feral horde, I would definitely hide away until the morning, until I can easily take care of them. So I'm not gonna be risking anything. It'll be, might be a boring horde, and I don't really care. Do not care. I'll try and make it interesting, but if not, and I'm just sitting there, then I'll either time-lapse it or just cut it out and start recording again in the morning before we start killing them. Because until I get a sleeping bag set up, I am not risking death again. That's, you have no idea how much of a pain in the ass it is to go across the water and to run all the way here. Not only that, we have to go and retrieve your shit, so if you die 2 miles away from home like we did last time, and then spawn 4 miles away from it, yeah, it takes a toll on you. I actually kind of got pretty pissed off. We do have lots of arrows, which is good, and we're always finding bird's nests since we're out here in the wilderness. Damn it, if I could hit him. Okay. Got up rather quick. Scavenging is going up, that's good. Now I wanted that deer, but I think it took off and now I don't know where the heck it went. Could actually upgrade my bow. Should maybe do that right now, actually, because it's not so bad. Let's get another wooden bow. See, 244. So yeah, that's my weapon crafting ability right now. Which ain't bad. Not too shabby. But I did grind out, like, 200 or more wooden clubs over the course of the evening last night. And then 200 and more before the evening before that, so does take quite a bit of a grind, but that's the way I like it. Kind of extends the late game and makes it a bit more challenging. I mean, you don't have to grind it out. Just let it come naturally, but I mean, you could be on day 56 and, you know, hardly any skill level if you don't grind a little bit. And with me doing a series like this, normally I don't grind quite that hard, but I want to fast track it as much as possible so you guys can see as much content as possible in a short period of time. So, yeah, that's kind of the reason behind that. But yeah, I hope you guys understand that I'm, you know, until I get sleeping bag set up, I'm not really going to piss around with the hordes too much. I'm going to hide like a little bitch. That'll be that. But now, like I said, I can probably get a sewing machine set up, and if I can get my sleeping bag crafted now that I got my beaker, who knows? I'm going to try and do that before the evening here. It's still 9 o'clock in the morning, so we got lots of time during the day. We should be alright. I just want to get this one more tree, and hopefully, if I can, just a couple more resource rocks. Nothing big. Get our trees planted closer to home. Start growing our tree farm. And it's good to do this every day, is to plant another tree every day, or another set of trees every day, at least four, so that we've always got fully grown trees. Like, if you harvest your first set, then the next day your next set should be coming in, and just keep a steady flow of trees going. But again, you have to do that every day, then you have to harvest the trees and plant them every day. Oh, there's the deer over there, so we'll grab him too next. And I'm gonna craft some arrows. So we have to keep those topped off. I don't wanna lose arrows. I'm surprised those dogs didn't come back after me. Usually, even after you leave the area, they still tend to come around and find you the next day or later on, but I haven't seen nothing or heard nothing from them yet. Killed me, I came back. They must have just despawned and that was it. Usually they don't despawn though, usually they hang around in the area, which is either an Alpha 14 change or just the fact because I died, and normally I don't die, so it's kind of all new to me. Normally if I just avoid the dogs and just leave them alone, they'll hang around. But maybe because I died, they tried to come after me at my new location or something? I don't know. I have no idea. Either way, I'm not too upset about it. I'm just happy I could get my stuff back easily. And my wellness is going back up because I've been cooking boiled meats. But now that I got my crafting table, and I believe we still have a wrench, actually we have quite a few wrenches, which is great, because now I can make a cooking grill, because I'd much rather not waste my jars of water on food and just make the grilled meats instead. So like I said, I just want to grab a couple more resource rocks. Be nice to get at least this one and one more. Then we'll head back and we'll start looking at what we can craft, and we'll hopefully get a sewing table set up and maybe a sewing machine. I don't know if we have a spring, but we're gonna need a spring, so we might have to go harvest a car, which is no big deal. So we need a spring, a nail. Oh, we don't have duct tape. Oh, but we can make duct tape now. Uh-huh. So yeah, we should be able to do it. Should be able to do it, no problem. Is that another deer over there? If it is, I want it. Excellent. Should actually be cleaning these core blocks up so that they don't cause a heat map horde or a screamer to show up. Oh, he's on top of a bird's nest. Oh, must have already got that one. Looking for another resource rock. I just want one more. Let's see how many stones we have. 264. Well, whatever. That'll allow me to craft another 100 clubs at least, or 100 stone axes tonight. We'll have to grind up some more stones tomorrow. Resource rock spawning is a little bit less. I don't really see as many resource rocks around as usual, which is fine. I guess they felt it needed to be nerfed. There was too many of them spawning in. Maybe it was causing lag. I don't really know. There, so we got those planted. Those trees are starting to grow, which is great. Alright, let's go check on this stuff. We'll actually be able to make some wooden frames, so that'll be good. Now let's see here, workbench. Craft one of those. I want to check out the tailoring table. Tailoring table will be wood, nails, and glue. So 20 wood, we have lots of wood. 15 more nails, we still have those. And now we'll need 5 more glue, so there it is. Boom. So craft one of those. When this is done, we'll take a look at that and see. We're gonna need a wrench, and we're gonna need a hammer too. So yeah, good thing we got a hammer. Awesome. Put this meat away. We are running out of storage space too, so it's high time that we got what we needed here. Chisel, I've already made the chisel. Okay, so where's our workbench? This is going to be interesting because I haven't seen one yet. Can't place it there now. I wanted to place it there. Could place it there. We'll just place it there. Okay, so. There are a lot of recipes in here, so. You're best to just type in by hand what you want. I want to see a sewing machine. See nails, a spring, forged iron, and duct tape. So none of that, like, we should be able to get that, no problem. So I'm going to work on that. Do our best to get that. Where is our tailoring table? Tailoring table. If I were to do some tailoring... Sorry, couch. We're in the way. Just put it there. Awesome. Okay, so now we'll have to get a sewing machine because all of these require a sewing machine as a tool before we can do anything. But yeah, I'll show you those recipes real quick. We can make every freaking clothing item in the game. So hopefully you guys like that. Oh yeah, and some of the blocks like the camo netting require sewing machine, the cloth blocks I figured would require that, mini bike seat requires that, but it also requires perks. Okay, so yeah, I want a storage chest. Just gonna require 10 nails, which we're gonna need more of. Boom. Ten nails, 10 wood, and requires a hammer. So we got that. We'll just craft one of those. I think we have another hammer somewhere too. Yeah, we got 2 more here, so that's good. We'll put them over here by our tools. So. Because we're going to want to get more of those set up. Now, I also want to get a dew collector at some point. We're going to need more duct tape. So I want to make more glue. In fact, I'm gonna make all of that. Yep, that's what we'll do. Lots of animal hides, so that's good. Put that away. Okay, give me my storage chest. Boom. There, now we actually have some storage. This in here. Okay, Okay, so I'm gonna put like start putting everything in here. I suppose everything that's already has a place, we'll just leave it for now. I do want to move some stuff out of here so I have more room. Are there empty jars in here? No, they're not. Okay. Come here, zombie. We can get that sledgehammer up and running. Seeing with the way I did the skill perks to making the sledgehammer at level 50 and then so on and so forth, this will actually make the sledgehammer useful and viable as a weapon. People actually really want to start craft that and start using it. I mean, I'd rather use it over this, so. So, yeah. Actually, where's a wrench? I'm gonna make sure I have a wrench. Where did I put them? What the heck? We had lots of them. We did have lots of wrenches. Am I blind? Oh, there. Okay, so I'm gonna take a couple wrenches. We're gonna go harvest some cars and try and get a spring and try and get a sewing machine. Spring. Okay, so we got a spring now. Excellent. Lots of springs. Gas. I don't know which stage gives us the engine. I think it's the first stage, so we passed up our chances on that after it broke down to the second stage. Awesome. Athletics is going up, so that's great. Up to 41 already. Get our wellness going back up here. Come on, wellness. Let's see, do we have any other cooked food? Do not actually. Okay, so yeah, I want short iron pipes. Where is that? Okay, so. Short. Let's see here. Give me 50. That's actually 100. Okay. Honestly, I just can't think right now. Okay, so I need forged iron. I need about 10 of these, so or 15 or something like that, so we'll wait till we have that. And I want ...15 forged iron. I don't think we have any kicking around. Yeah, no, so we'll make more of that. Let's see here, we'll get our wrench, put that up there. Now we can make a cooking grill, so we'll craft that. Awesome. So we'll actually stop that for right now. And then, what do we need for the sewing machine? So we need 5 duct tape. So where's our cloth? Duct, oops. duct tape, so we need 5 of that. And one spring, which we've got now. We're gonna have forged iron and one nail. We got 6, so 3 more. Hurry up, hurry up. Just want to get this on the go. We're going to need a bunch of cotton. So I'll have to go grab cotton. Okay, now we can make the sewing machine. So craft that. While it's crafting, I'm going to go grab cotton, so that we can actually make a sleeping bag. It's going to take about 40 cotton. We've already got the cloth, so I'm not too worried about the cloth portion of it. Just need the cotton for the stuffing. Because I imagine making a sleeping bag just out of cloth, no insulation, then it would probably not work so good. Since cotton's so abundant and easy to find, it's having lots of it for the cost of the sleeping bag, for the ability to respawn. I think it's fairly well balanced. I wanted to make it the survival aspect more survivally. So I mean, the first few days until you get your workbench set up, you know, it feels like survival. And when you die, you're screwed. You really don't want to die. Trust me. Been there, done that 3 times already. So we got 41 cotton, that should be enough. And it is raining. Sewing machine should be done when we get back, so we can go straight into crafting the sleeping bag. Might need some cordage, but I think I've already got that, so no big deal there. There's our sewing machine and our cooking grill, so we'll put that in here. What's going on there? Oh, because it's cooking. I think. Better be reason why it's locked. That's new, I've never seen a lock message on there before. Okay, sewing machine. So now we want our sleeping, or bedroll, sorry. We don't call it a sleeping bag anymore. Craft that. Awesome. We'll actually be able to respawn here now. So maybe I will take on the 7-day horde, which it's coming close to. So we're actually going to cut the video here. And next video will be me hiding in probably that house over there from the 7-day horde. So I'll see you guys in the next one.